One fateful day in the land of Brigdonia, King Travis the 104th, mightiest of kings, the most handsome of heroes, the most modest man among manly men, was unhappy. Sure, he had a palace full of miniature servants who peeled grapes, passed them down a line, and shot them from a cannon into his mouth. Sure, he had the most beautiful smile in the land, rumored to have brought a kitten back to life. And sure, he had an unrivaled reputation for rescuing princesses and towers, such as Princess Shaylin of the land of Gutierrez, or Princess Shayla of the land of giant three-eyed spiders.
Oh, come on!
And of course, Princess Sonliza, in the land of Cute, in which many of the citizens who had trouble living up to the title had grown to regret letting the 11-year-old princess rename the kingdom. But it wasn't what he had that was bothering him. It was what he did not have. And what he did not have was his crown. It was missing, and so the king set forth to secretly meet with his most trusted subject, the scribe Kenthusla.
Watch me whip, whip, whip. Watch me say hey, hey.
Ugh. Those weren't even the right words. It's just sad.